everybody. This is Azar. I'm a physical therapist. Today we're going to talk about some advanced strengthening exercises. In the previous videos, we talked about the exercises for the knee that you can do for generally to strengthen and stretch your knee when you have pain. But we haven't been talking about the very advanced strengthening exercises. Definitely make sure that you know these exercises are not for people that just had surgery, or not for the people that they have very, very severe pain or severe tear or something else. So if that's for the people that have a chronic knee instability or chronic knee injuries, that they wanted to address that with some exercises. The first one that I want to show you is the squat. So we did talk about the wall squat before. Now I'm going to talk about the squat that we are not being supported with the wall. Make sure your buttocks is in the back, your knees are open. Make sure you don't see your tippy toes, and your you can't see your tippy toes without your kneecap covering them. This is wrong. The kneecap's covering the tippy toes. This is correct. The kneecap's not covering, your booty's back, you're straight, and you go up and down just like that. Again, when your knees open, you can get more glute strengthening along with the quadriceps strengthening. If you don't have a kneecap issue or patellofemoral problem, you can go more than 90 degrees if it doesn't hurt and do this. Another exercise you can do is going to be a single leg squat. You can do the single leg squat just like that. This is a very good quadriceps strengthening in advanced stage. I like that. I do it a lot. Make sure your kneecap's a little towards the outside. If you don't have a balance, you can put your tippy toes down on the other side. It's not a balance, it's mostly for the strengthening, so if you have to put your tippy toes, do it. The next exercise you can do this on some kind of cushiony thing, so makes it more of a balance exercise at the same time. So you squat on some kind of cushion. You have to have a better balance and use your core for this one. Okay? Very good. The next advanced strengthening exercise I want to show you is the hamstring cruise chain exercise. We haven't been talking about hamstring a lot. This hamstring exercise, you need to have a rolling chair. So you're going to have one leg on the floor, the leg that you need to strengthen your hamstring. And you're going to pull this chair forward. You all probably have a rolling chair somewhere at home, like an office or something, and you're gonna do this one more time. We're gonna roll that chair forward using our hamstring muscle. You can tighten up your core too. Okay, so the next exercise, you're gonna have the band, and that's gonna be like a screen push that you can do in the gym. So you have a screen and a press, leg press in the gym. You can do this, press, relax, press and hold, relax, press and hold, relax. If you want, if you don't have a kneecap problem, again, you can go more than 90 degrees with long arc and then do it as much as you can. Hold there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, relax. Okay, this is a leg press. Another one you can use, you can have this on and do that squatting with the sidewalk. It's a very good glute and quad strengthening. So glute medius and quads, even glute maximus are working. I like that one. Make sure your knees are open. Okay. If you want to make it harder, you can put this lower. I even like to put it under my feet and go like this. Okay. This is a very good advanced strengthening exercise. Again, you can go a little lower, make it harder. Okay, make sure you have a good posture, okay? The next one you can do, you can do the step exercises on top of something. If you have a step at home, fine. If you don't, then you can put a hard cushion or something, or a lot of have books on top of each other. And then you're gonna go sidestepping. Okay. Okay, and front stepping also. Front stepping. Okay. These are the step exercises. Okay. Another exercise you can do is sometimes you have lack of extension that chronically stays there. Make sure you do a lot of hamstring stretch, or you can put your leg on top of something and stretch your hamstring. And if you have a chronic lack of flexion and tightness here, definitely make sure you do a lot of this daily. Stay for 30 seconds and relax. Another way of having the treating the lack of extension, sometimes you do everything and still you have lack of extension. Sometimes that's because of the gastrocnemius is so tight. Gastrocnemius used to be an ankle muscle, but because it's double jointed, it works on the knee also. Sometimes forgotten for the knee problems. That's how we're gonna stretch the gastroc. Make sure your knees are straight, your heels on the floor, and you are lunging to stretch your gastroc and holding for 30 seconds. Okay? Sometimes your knee flexion is still not strong enough, because knee flexion happens with the hamstring, which we already talked about, and it can happen with the gastroc also. So you can do the single leg heel raises to make sure you can strengthen your gastrocnemius also. So another thing that you need to keep in mind is bicycle is very important. Stationary bike in the even in the early stage of surgery is important too, but definitely in the advanced exercises you can give it resistance, and treadmill is good. You can do that. Elliptical is good. You can put resistance on that too. Step exercise, definitely. Jogging at the last stage, jumping. You can do a lot of jumping exercises with the squat. You can mix the jumping with the squat like this way. You squat jump a little bit. Okay, you can do it in different directions. You can do it single leg, double leg. These are all for the advanced strengthening exercises of the knee. I hope you could enjoy this video, and if everything else is done and you're ready for advanced strengthening, these are the good videos for you. Thank you. Have a good day.